We know Jupiter is nothing like Earth. It's a massive gas giant, 600 million kilometers away. Jupiter's upper cloud layer is composed almost entirely of hydrogen and helium, but we don't know much about what goes on under this obscuring layer. In 2011, NASA launched the spacecraft Juno on a 5-year-long trip to investigate Jupiter's deep structures. In 2016, Juno reached Jupiter and began a series of orbits that revealed Jupiter's poles for the first time. Images captured by the Juno cam show the characteristic color banding of the equator, giving way to clusters of cyclonic storms, some of them up to 1,400 kilometers across. At the equator, the craft spotted an unexpected plume of ammonia rising above the planet's gassy surface. Juno has also been using its onboard microwave radiometer to peer deep below Jupiter's upper cloud layer, where pressures can be hundreds of times stronger than on Earth. Jupiter's atmosphere is not well mixed. There are structures deep under the outer cloud layer, and they don't line up with the bands we've been able to see until now. Here's a first look at Jupiter's southern auroras, captured by the spacecraft. The behavior of auroras on Earth is largely dictated by the Sun, but findings suggest that Jupiter's magnetic field is up to 50% stronger than expected in some areas, and may be affected by the planet's own rotation. Juno's only completed 6 orbits so far, but already the data is showing that our understanding of gas giants may not line up with reality. Up next, Juno will set its sights on one of Jupiter's most mysterious features, the Big Red Spot. In July 2017, Juno will do a flyby of the giant storm, hoping to shed some light on its origins, how it's maintained, and just how far down it goes. The spacecraft's mission will come to an end in early 2018, when it will intentionally crash into Jupiter's upper atmosphere. Until then, Juno will be collecting massive amounts of data, which will not only give us a better understanding of Jupiter's origins, but maybe even offer a glimpse of how the solar system came to be. Thank you.